Hello, learners. Best greetings of the time to all of you. I am Mr. Shashikant Gosavi, Assistant Professor at Walchand Institute of Technology. Today I am presenting an online educational resource on cycle time of earth moving equipments as a part of the course Construction Methodology and Town Planning. To begin with, we will start with the learning outcomes of this video. The learning outcomes of the video are, at the end of this session, the learner will be able to analyze the cycle time of the earth moving equipment. In addition to that, the learner will also be able to calculate the total time for completing the work for cycle time of the earth moving equipments. Dear friends, the cycle time is relevant to almost all operations. Every operation is having cyclic nature, then cycle time becomes relevant. For example, in many earth moving equipments, we need to excavate the earth, then we have to transfer it towards the hauling equipment, and then hauling equipment will reach to the dumping site. And again, the next cycle of excavation will continue. Here, you can see that the cycle time can be in different units, but the basic unit that is normally considered is 1 hour. The production rate will be a maximum if the work is performed at the same rate during the whole hour. The interruptions and delay are unavoidable. Therefore, there will be some relaxation for that. A machine or worker may work only for 45 minutes in 1 hour. That is the assumption for taking into consideration the interruptions and delays. The actual production rate, which is also called as the efficiency factor, is taken as 45 by 60 or 0.75 hour of the maximum production rate. The loader cycle time and the hauler cycle time are the two times which are normally considered in case of the cycle time of complete operation. The loader cycle time is the time it takes the loading equipment to load the truck plus waiting for the truck to be spotted. So this is classically the time taken by the excavating equipment and loading equipment alone. The truck cycle time, however, is immediately after the loading cycle. That means it is the time the loaded truck takes to travel to the dump site, unload the material, return to the loading unit, and be reloaded. Here I have shown it in a cycle that the loader will be consisting of 5 major steps. First step is movement of the empty bucket to the bottom of the excavation pit. Bucket is the excavator part which actually deals with the material excavation. Then next step will be excavation of the soil or the rock. Third step will be filling the bucket of the excavator. Fourth step will be swinging of the beam towards the dump truck, and finally loading the dump truck. Once again, the arrow reaches back to the first step where movement of the empty bucket to the bottom of the excavator pit happens. There are several cycle time uncertainties for which 10% variability is normally considered. It all depends upon the experience of the operator, visibility conditions, soil formation, and the environment and weather conditions. This is a classical drag line. There can be shovel, there can be backhoe, there can be several some such excavator. Here I have shown you the drag line wherein a bucket is seen over here. The drag line bucket is supposed to fall down onto the material. It will be dragged by from the cabin with the help of this cable, and then it will collect the material. Once again, this bucket, as soon as it is full, it will be lifted up. Then it will be transferred at an appropriate location where the dumping will happen. The time for haul loaded and return empty. This is the travel time of a hauling equipment. which depends on the speed of the vehicle, which indirectly depends on the vehicle type, the traffic condition, the conditions of the road, and several other factors are there which influence onto the travel time. The cycle time for transportation material I have explained with the help of an example. Here, let us assume that 175 tons of the sand is to be dealt with, which is to be transported. The density of the material, that is sand, is assumed to be 1.75 tons per cubic meter. The distance of the transport is 7 kilometer. Dump truck capacity is 10 cubic meter. Two laborers and a driver are assumed to be there for loading. Remember, I am not expecting the loading equipment in the first case. So there are these people who will be loading at the rate of 1.5 cubic meter per hour. The haul speed is 30 kilometers per hour and return speed is 40 kilometers per hour, because during the return journey it will be empty. It takes 3 minutes to unload the truck. The actual working time is 45 minutes in 1 hour. That means 15 minutes are possibly some of the interruptions because of which that has been reduced. Now, with all these consideration, determine the total time. That is the example. Here, volume of the sand is 175 cubic meter, while 1.75 is the density, and therefore 100 cubic meter will be the total volume that is to be dealt in this example. The cycle time analysis is consisting of loading time, which is 10 divided by 3 into 1.5. 10 is the truck capacity, 3 number of laborers are there including driver, and capacity of each one of them is 1.5, and therefore 10 divided by 3 into 1.5, it gives us 2.22 hour. The hauling speed is known, hauling distance is known, and therefore you can calculate the time required for that, which works out to be 0.233 hours. The dumping is said to be 3 minutes. We are converting it in hour, and therefore it becomes 0.05 hour. Return time is again 7 divided by 40. 40 is the speed, which is faster as compared to the hauling speed, and it is 0.175 hours. Total cycle time in this way works out to be 2.22 plus 0.23 plus 0.05 plus 0.175, giving us the whole time which is required for one cycle. The production rate in this case is important for us to understand. Number of trips per hour in this particular case will be 1 divided by 2.68. 2.68 was the final answer of one cycle, and therefore number of trips per hour will be 0.373. Quantity hauled per trip will be 10 meter cube multiplied by 0.373, that is giving me 3.73 cubic meter per hour. Production rate is 2.8 meter cube per hour based on the upper values. The time using one truck and two laborers, time taken to transport 100 cubic meter of the sand will be 100 divided by 2.8, which works out to be close to 35 hours. Please pause the video. Instead of manual loading of the sand, if a truck loader is used having a production rate of 75 cubic meter per hour, what will be the cycle time? Please calculate and keep your answer ready for comparison. The solution is, in this case, the total cycle time required will be 0.591 hours. This is changing because the loading time which was required manually was considerably higher as compared to the loading time that we are considering in this case. The production rate is number of trips per hour, once again 1 divided by 0.591, which is 1.690, and thus at the end we get time taken to transport 100 cubic meter of the sand as 7.88 hours. Remember very well that because the loading time has increased, the earlier case time was quite more as compared to what we are requiring right now. The production rate and rest of the factors like hauling time are not going to be significantly different than the earlier case. My dear friends, for preparation of this particular online educational resource, I have used the references like Methods and Equipment for Construction by Ahmed Alam Mani, and Optimization of the Load and Haul Operations at an Open Cast Colliery by School of Mining Engineering, University of Pretoria, South Africa. Thank you very much.